situation at the convention center till yesterday. When yesterday did you become aware?
I think it was yesterday morning when we first found out about it. We were just as surprised as everybody else. We didn't know that the city had used that as a staging area. That shows how difficult communications are.
FEMA's been on the ground for 4 days, going into the fifth day. Why no massive airdrop of food and water? In Banda Aceh, in Indonesia, they got a food drop 2 days after the tsunami struck.
We're feeding those people in the convention center. We have fed over 150,000 people as of last night. That is happening.
But I guess the point is, as of last night, sir, forgive me, I have to stop you here.
What we're hearing is that we're hearing people's frustration. There are people that are beginning to manifest themselves out of the community that we didn't know that were there.
Why are you discovering this now? It's 5 days that FEMA's been on the ground. The head of police says it's been 5 days that FEMA's been there. The mayor, the former mayor, putting out SOSs on Tuesday morning, crying on national television, saying, please send in some troops. So the idea that, yes, I understand that you're feeding people and trying to get in there now, but it's Friday. It's Friday. It was baffling to me how you could have what was at that point a sort of official estimate of 50,000 people at the convention center and not know about it and have no idea. The other thing that was surprising to me was that he seemed to have no intelligence. At one point I said, how can we have better intel than you have? Because I have a research file prepared by my 23-year-old research assistant, a production assistant, and I'm getting better intelligence than you're getting? How is that possible? It was really baffling. I mean, it was really one of the more baffling interviews because they seemed so out of touch with the reality that I think a lot of people had been watching day after day after day.
Michael Brown is kind of a valet for the oil lobby. His specialty was doing junkets for the oil crowd. He'd get them a hunting lodge up in Wyoming where they could have two perfect weeks to get away. And so he slowly worked his way up the ladder in that way. And he was given FEMA, which is it's like giving somebody the ambassadorship to Luxembourg or something as a patronage.
Who knew that Bush had appointed the head of the Arabian Horse Association to run FEMA?
New Orleans was on the hit list of three worst disaster zones: a terrorist attack in New York, earthquake San Francisco, breach levees in New Orleans. Instead, FEMA and Homeland Security treated the hurricane as if the levees never